Naitwa Boke Chacha. Nina miaka 12. Mimi nimezaliwa katika kijiji cha Maburi wilayani Serengeti. Wazazi wangu walitaka nikeketwe lakini mimi nilikataa. Kwa maana yake kuwa msichana kukeketwa kuna madhara mengi. Kwanza msichana anaweza akatoka na damu nyingi wakati wa kujifungua. Pili, msichana anaweza akapatwa na maambukizi ya virusi vya ukimwi wakati wa kukeketwa. Wazazi wangu walipanga tarehe ya mimi kukeketwa. Niliwaambia madhara ya msichana kukeketwa lakini walikataa. Zilipokuwa zimebakia siku chache za mimi kukeketwa, nilikimbia nikaenda kwa mchungaji wa Anglikana. Alinipokea na nikamwelezea kuwa wazazi wangu wanataka kunikeketa. Ndipo alipompigia simu dada Robi akaja. Nikaenda naye katika kituo cha polisi cha Mgumu. Nilikuwa nikiongea huku akiandika. Wazazi wangu ndipo walipoitwa, kumbe walikamatwa. Ndipo ahidi kwa maandishi kuwa hawatanikeketa, wakinikeketa watafungwa. Na mimi nataka kuwashukuru kanisa la Anglikana kwa kutoa elimu juu ya madhara ya kukeketa wasichana. Kwa kweli wasichana wengi wamekeketwa kwa sababu hawajui watakimbia wapi wala wataenda wapi.
Naitwa Gati Mwita. Nina miaka 15. Naishi katika kijiji cha Maburi, Serengeti. Ninasoma kidato cha kwanza. Baba na mama walitaka wanikekete. Nikakataa. Nikasema kukeketwa kwanza kuna madhara mengi. Au kupata virusi vya ukimwi au kutokwa na damu nyingi.
We have heard that these girls, when they were explaining on how they flee from the FGM from their parents, of course this is a real situation which is there in our villages. So these girls, they have to escape going to some of the pastors in our churches there to the community for them to be safe. Because some they cannot run even to the village leaders, because even the village leaders are one of the among the people to the community who are running that practice of FGM. You may get a village chairman, but also taking his girls to undergo the FGM. So this is the challenge. So these girls, they need to have a safe space for them to go there, but also to continue getting their basic needs. So only going to the pastor's house, sometimes there are some challenges in. You know, these churches are around the community. Sometimes these people could organize themselves, or those the relatives or the girls could organize themselves and go to fight to the pastor's house. Why are they keeping their girl in the house? So we need to have a safe house to overcome these challenges. And I know that most of the girls, if they will know that there is a safe place where they could run for their safe to escape the FGM, we are going to receive many girls who will flee from FGM. After having the memorandum of understanding between the parents and the police, so we also have a meeting together with the social welfare officers, community development officers from Serengeti district, to have a common understanding of all together. So this development officers, they do make a follow-up to the parents to see this girl, how is she doing, but also social welfare. But also our churches, we are also having that activity of making follow-up to these girls to see how are they proceeding, because some are experiencing some challenges when they go back. Some of the bad words from the parents, you know, what you did is very bad, it is very bad to our tribe, so you make us ashamed, you see, like that. But they are not taking a girl to undergo the practice, but they are still giving some hard words to the girl. So when we visit there, we visit their households, we get the information from a girl, maybe she will be at the school, we meet her, but we come again to the parents and still making, talking to them on how they should, they're supposed to be, not to give those hard words to the girls. So this is how we are doing, but these are only two. But in 2012, it was a season of cutting. We experienced to have 16 girls who were free from FGM. So we always communicate with our pastors in our churches to the community to support us. But not only Anglicans, even we are working with other denominations like Roman Catholic, PAG, Pentecostal, Apostolic, but also Muslims to their mosque. So we talk to these shehe pastors, or we can work together to make sure that we save these girls who are free from FGM, to provide them good environment while they communicate. After they receive, they communicate with our head office in Mugumu, and then we make a follow-up to go there, to take them and to make a memorandum of understanding, having a meeting with social welfare, community development officer, police gender desk, and the other people to make the parents to be committed themselves. So please help us to build this safe house.